What's up, YouTube? Zero here. Welcome to the place where gamers, witches, wizards, and superheroes unite. That's right, I got another loot gaming crate. Yes, this is not a trick. If you just watched my April 2021 video and you're here, I believe this is the March 2021 video. What happened was I was on vacation. I had the mail hold my mail for a week while I was on vacation. And both of these showed up on my doorstep when the end mail happened. So, this is, I believe, the March 2021 box. So that's right, I'm opening both on the same day. I was just lucky enough to come back from vacation, and what I think of these as are gifts. I never know what's inside, so I think of them as little presents. So it's time to open up March 2021, which is called Death. Hopefully March 2021 is in here. I'm gonna look like an idiot. And here we go. Is it Death? I think it is. I think it is Death. In the Death box, for those of you who may not have looked what was going to be inside, it should really be called a Bethesda crate. It has Deathloop, it has Fallout, and it has Skyrim, which are all Bethesda games. So this is a Bethesda crate. Let's take a look at this. It is a stash box. I don't know what's in a stash box. So let's check it out and open this box with my handy dandy pocket knife. Let's see what's inside a stash box. Hopefully there's some money in it. I could go for $1 million right now, loot crate. And let's take a look at the outside of this stash box. You can see stash, a Fallout stash box. You can see the top. Hopefully you can see the top. It's a little tough to read because of the lighting. I apologize for that. But let's take a look at the side. We also got stash here. So we got stash everywhere. So that is a cool item. And it opens. Oh my god, we got more goodies inside. We actually got some goodies inside. It's not $1 million. Nope, it is. So unfortunately, not $1 million. Not even in Fallout, it's not $1 million. Let's take a look at what we got. Yeah, it looks like we got some Fallout items, actually. I don't think I can use these in-game, but I can pretend I'm in-game. So it looks like that we have a flag right here. You see the tire on the bottom. I don't want to, like, destroy this, but it's pretty small. You can see, compared to my hand, how big it is. My hands aren't that big, unfortunately. I hated making that on camera. I don't know why I did it. But you can see the item. It is a flag. Not bad. Kind of looks like Brotherhood of Steel. Then we got a Fallout 76. I don't know. These might be stickers. I think they're stickers. But we have a Fallout 76. I'm going to call it a sticker. We have Welcome to West Virginia. Let's see. Nice and shiny. Then we have, yeah, Camden Park. Nice sticker. See that? Then we have New River Gorge Resort Adventure Awaits. Another cool sticker. I don't know what I could do with stickers, but I'll figure it out. I'll put them somewhere to make my house look more like Fallout. A post nuclear wasteland. Exactly what I want my house to look like. And we have Welcome to Point Pleasant. So, a nice little stash box with a stash inside. I'm gonna put these back inside. I'm going to store my stickers in the stash box now because I have nowhere else to store my stickers. So now it's in the stash box. Okay, this is a nice, I'm gonna call it a water bottle, workout bottle. Coffee mug, if you want. It looks like a coffee mug. But what it is, and I'm going to open this up, it is a Nern root extract from the Elder Scrolls. That is pretty awesome, and it actually has measuring on the side. I'm not sure if you could see that in the video, unfortunately. You might be able to catch a glare of it, but there is measuring on both sides, so you know how much you're filling up if you want to fill it up. I mean, this is a nice item. Very usable. You can see inside we have a filter and then some more stuff inside of here, and we have a keychain. I don't think you want to drink this. We have a keychain inside of the Narn root extract. Make sure you don't drink it. If any of you get this, don't just put water in here. You can, there's actually a thing on the side that you can hook this in and you can carry it around on a backpack. That's actually really nice. If you have a backpack and you want to put some water in it, instead of putting it in one of those pockets where you have to worry about it falling out, now you can just hook it on. So I really like that. That's my favorite part of it, honestly. But no, this is a great item, of course. I love usable items. Any item that I can get that I can use, and I do wear a backpack into work. So this is a great item. I can put whatever I want in here. You can see the different stuff they have in here, kind of like a thermos where you could, I guess, put more stuff in here. But it's a nice item. It has a couple of cool goodies inside. Again, make sure that you do not drink it with the keychain in there unless you want extra, I don't know, aluminum. You want extra aluminum in your diet. Probably not a good idea. Make sure you take it out. Anyway, the Narn root extract, I'm gonna call it a water bottle. Really nice item. Again, I really love the fact that it can hang. It can hang off your belt if your arm's too tired to hold it. Again, it is great for hiking, going into work if you wear a backpack. Very usable and great item. Let's take a look at the t-shirt because it is hitting me in the face and it is a Deathloop t-shirt. The whole t-shirt's filled up. You can see on the bottom it says Deathloop, and now I'm gonna kind of zoom in. It's really a dark t-shirt, honestly. Let me get some more light on it for you. It's actually a pretty cool t-shirt. I'm excited for the game Deathloop. I've seen a couple of things on it, and it looks like a cool game. But this is a decent shirt. It has the orange, the man in the circle trying to escape the Deathloop, and then the Deathloop on the bottom. And the shirt's pretty much taken up. Again, it's another black shirt if you just watched my video with a little bit of art in the middle, but it's decent art, it's readable, and that's what I like when Loot Crate comes with these type of shirts. We've had shirts that are very unreadable, and it's kind of pointless to have a shirt like that. If people can't read what's on your shirt, what's the point of it? I was actually walking around in Arizona on vacation, and people were complimenting me on some of my Loot Crate shirts because it was readable. They knew the game. It was Fallout shirts. And that's what I prefer. I don't want a shirt that people don't know what it is or can't read it. I like having that discussion with random people about video games. That's just me, though. But let's take a look at the pin, though. One of my favorite parts of these loot crates, of course. I'm a pin collector. And I cheated. I looked in the PDF before the video, but this is just called a death pin. Obviously, a skull. A very nice item. Really cool. I like skulls. So that is great. And then we have a Skyrim print. I think it said Skyrim. It's definitely Elder Scrolls, but I'm pretty sure the PDF said Skyrim. Let's take a look. It looks like Skyrim. So let's take a look at this print. Trying to not ruin it. It looks like a pretty cool print. Let's take a step back so you can make sure you get a bunch of the light. And it's a little dark. Unfortunately, I'm recording this pretty late. But it is a cool print. So that is all of the items in the box. I gotta say, I do really love that water bottle. That's probably my favorite item in this box. Thank y'all for sticking around until the end. I really do appreciate it. Make sure you hit that thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel for more mystery box unboxing videos. I hope you have a great rest of your day. Until next time, peace.